game tonight featuring the New York Knicks as they go up against the Bulls in Chicago. Last game for the Bulls, they ended up with a loss to the Warriors.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, sir. Let's do it. Yes, sir. Yo.
Welcome, everyone. Let's get ready for some NBA basketball on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. And joining us a bit later from the sidelines, Doris Burke. The New York Knicks are in the United Center tonight to battle it out with one of their longtime rivals, the Chicago Bulls. Defeated by the Pelicans in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
And what stands out from that game, Clark, is that they let a lot of points slip through their fingers at the free throw line.
Here's Parker, following the score by Walt Frazier. And it's good. Fought through contact, hits the shot, he'll go to the free throw line. Well, Tony Parker, an excellent scorer. Creative finisher, certainly inside with a smooth pull-up jump shot from mid-range. Steve, when he gets in the lane, he is dynamite. And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Collison kicks to Frazier. In to Tim Duncan. The shot will not go, so the Bulls will take it the other way.
And as much as we talk about...
Oh, what a throwdown there. Man.
It is possible. I don't know what all that meant, but you're right, Clark.
Now here's Duncan. Takes a shot at the elbow, and it's in after a nice bounce off the right side. Duncan's got it. Frazier outside. Screen by Duncan. Out to Schrempf. Good. Great play set up by Frazier. Schrempf's got his first points in this one. Kicks it out to Jones. This one for three. Rodman grabs the miss.
Boy, but he was close, Kevin, to making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, he had a really good look. I mean, he'll knock that down more often than not.
He's always been one of my favorite guys to watch, and an elite shooting guard on the court. I mean, the issue with him has been health. You know, last season, he missed about a month.
Collison against Rubio. Stolen by Collison. And here we go with Collison running it up the court. That's good.
That's how you make an impact with defense. Once
he kicks it to Scott. Shot clock at six. Goes up the baseline. And again, Chicago. No good. It's Schrempf on the wing. Pass to Frazier. No good. Great D that time from Kemp. A three ball.
Oh, he just knocked down the buzzer, Peter.
Boy, ends the quarter with a dead-eye three as the buzzer sounds.
They had that set up, I think, Steve, and he timed it perfectly.
About what we've seen so far from the Bulls.
I was impressed with their transition game, guys. They really got out and ran the lanes.
Yeah, they did. I mean, no better way to get easy buckets than through fast breaks.
They've got Ginobili. Kemp is out there with Horford. Then it's Ricky Rubio. And it's Harper in at the shooting guard position. So that's the five in the game for Chicago.
Very nice pickup of the offensive rebound. Once he gets his hands on it, you know it's going back
up. NBA. His father feels as if he's been a mature horse since he started playing at the French Training Institute. Parker's father said, quote, "I don't think you can get any more mature than that. Leaving home at 14, you have to become a man on your own."
Outside Harper. Up top, Kemp. Into Al Horford. And he floats in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one. Some nice passing by New York here. With the fadeaway. And he gets it to go. Anthony against Harper. He took good advantage of that screen.
Great job of utilizing it.
Well, we're getting to watch two of the best teams in the NBA at the defensive end. Very difficult to score on these clips.
The first one falls. Scotty's checked in for Harper. All free throws good from Tucker.
Another trip to the stripe for him, and I tell you what, a little bit of a different feel here in the second quarter. A little more banging going on.
This team is never afraid to get physical.
Parker outside. It's taken away by Collison. Here's the break on up the court. And that one's good. Frazier's got 6 points. And a Ricky Rubio, an incredible passer, but his scoring has lagged, Clark. In fact, one of the worst field goal percentages in modern history of the NBA.
Yeah, that's really incredible. And for Rubio, his offensive struggles are not just because of his jump shot. He also struggles to finish around the rim, given his size advantage most nights. You'd expect that to be his strength, and that's where I think he could really improve.
You know, with the time left, they can trade 2-for-1 here.
If they hurry.
Frazier kicks to Duncan from 12 feet out. Good. Great play set up by Frazier. Frazier's got his fourth assist in this one.
And they've set up countless buckets off assists. That's a huge part of what they've been doing here today. A
lot of dime dropping going on out there, Steve.
The shot and game clock separated by 4. Scott with a screen on Rodman. Ariza with it. Guarded now by Dennis Rodman. And that one's good. Parker.
And he came off that screen. The defense just couldn't get over the top. Beautiful play.
Yep, and without a hand in his face, he's going to bury those.
Now Frazier, who's coming off a 13-point game against New Orleans.
You know what was great, too, Kevin, was the way he balanced getting his own shots and making plays for others.
Close game as we wrap up the second quarter. Knicks lead by 2. We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half of basketball.
It's been a good one for Parker. He's got 11 points and a steal. The motor on this guy is amazing. Completely revved up. He's been everywhere today.
He sure has, Clark. Both ends of the floor. I mean, his offense has been great, but defensively he's brought huge energy, too.
Chicago trailing here. On the court for the Knicks. Rodman is out there with Schrempf. Then there's Frazier. And it's Duncan. And it's Collison in at the point. Kemp with the bucket.
Guys, he's one of
them. Collison kicks to Schrempf. All sorts of time. The shot's good. Collison making the play. Schrempf's got 8.
At his current age. I mean, he looks much as he did early in his career. His game has really withstood the test of time. And I think it's partly due to his conditioning, but his IQ is a big factor. And his game has always been one that's been anchored in fundamentals and staying close to the ground.
Now let's go to Doris Burford from his players. Doris, thank you. Harper, he's checked in for Chicago. Schrempf kicks to Frazier. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. Frazier's got 8 points. It's Schrempf on the wing. He's guarded by Harper. Good.
That's 10 straight points on mid-range jump shots.
Back to Collison. Shoots. And it's Chicago with the rebound. This, their first look at this year's New York squad.
And I'll tell you what, even though they looked like the better team a year ago, they only managed a split of the season series.
He wanted their offense to run through Ginobili. Coach emphasized getting him as many touches as possible, saying he is going to be one of the guys to carry us the rest of the way.
And for Horford, you know, able to scrap inside to overcome his lack of size defensively, his quickness is his biggest advantage. I mean, he's excellent at moving in space and defending the pick and roll.
Ricky Rubio checked in for Jones. And Garnett gets it to go on the assist from Tuckerson. Rubio the pass to Horford. Down low, Harper. And he bangs it home with one hand. Frazier kicks it to Tucker. Garnett inside. Defended by Scott. Shot's good by Garnett. 34 seconds left to play in the third. Down low. Here's Ginobili. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
They've got to continue to put pressure on the defense by probing inside. That's what's really working for them.
And when you're doing the job they are inside, it takes pressure off the perimeter guys.
Collison kicks it to Tucker. Back to Collison. He dishes it to Frazier. Allen Bear inside. And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. D'Alembert has got the lead up to six now for New York. Here's Ginobili. No luck. And we've watched three so far in this one. New York ahead, leading by six. And when we return, we'll get the fourth quarter rolling right here on 2K Sports. State Farm assist of the game.
Well, no question, this was going to be the winner. Just take a look at the expertise he shows on this pass. Perfectly timed and beautifully placed.
And it's the Bulls with the ball. 6-point game. Horford dishes to Parker. Six on the shot clock. He was all alone on that one. Ariza's got the first field goal of the fourth quarter here for the Bulls.
An extremely strong finisher. I'm surprised he wasn't able to power that through the defense.
Lambeer kicks to Anthony. Sinks the triple. And the Knicks lead by six. Outside, Jones. Kemba screen on D'Alembert. Here's Parker. And it's good. He planted his feet on the pick and shield the defender off. The shot. Second shot opportunity. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
Chicago needs to do a better job guarding against Garnett.
He's got 8 points, and he's added a steal to his stat line also.
Now, that's obviously not a big number, but you know, he's been doing some valuable defensive work for him.
Garnett, the screen. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Beautiful job angling his body, shielding the big man from the ball on his way to the basket.
That's really the only way to do it if you're going to take it down there amongst the tall trees.
Outside, Jones. Back to Parker. Right through the shoulder that time. All net.
His shooting has been so good today.
Horford sets a screen for Parker. Jones, that's for two. Another one falls for Chicago.
That's a big basket there. You can expect him to be.
Frasier kicks to Schrempf. .14 left in the fourth quarter of this one, and he gets it to go. And the Knicks lead by four. Tim Duncan, he's checked in for Lambeer.
Substitution for Knicks.
1:11 left in the fourth quarter. Stolen by Collison.
Passes to Duncan.
Schrempf dishes to Duncan. Fades away. No good. Now Chicago takes it the other way, and he commits the intentional foul. Count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line. That's going to send Walt Frazier to the line. It's going to go on Eddie Jones. Back to Frazier. Shot clock at six. Misses the lane.
Hey, I like creativity and the circus finish as much as anybody. But you better be sure you got a chance to make it. Great idea to pull up and take the transition three there. The D was in position to block his path to the hoop if he took it inside.
Shoots it, hits the jump hook.
Walt Frazier.
So it's New York picking up the win. Both teams played well, but these guys had the edge.
Yeah, I think so. They were just steak knife sharp. Very on top of their game here.
Well said. Sports. Now our Jordan player of the game.